And now, coming to you live from the John Wilkes recording booth in lovely Richmond, Virginia, it's the Stonewall Jackson 5.
All right, everybody, welcome to the Stonewall Jackson 5. I'm your host tonight, Tubby. I am joined with ZP.
Hello.
Kaiser.
What's up?
BBC Flip.
Yeah.
How you gentlemen doing tonight?
Good, man.
Are both of those Bs necessary?
They are very pertinent. Yes.
Is it LBC? Is it MBC? Is it?
It's BBC.
All
right. It's a real uncomfortable start to the episode.
You've been in the showers with him, I'm sure you know.
Oh, yeah. Shower nightly.
He tripped me a couple times.
So, before we get into the True Detective talk, what you guys been up to?
I've been training a new guy at work, so I've been busy as fuck this week. Like, fucking super busy, but that's about it, man. Fucking, I've been working overtime this week and shit, too, so this is a good little break for me this week.
Nice.
I'm the new guy at Kaiser's work. Been going pretty easy on my end. I don't know what the fuck he's talking about.
Have you been learning anything from Kaiser?
Not a goddamn thing. I mean, I'm the new guy. I feel like I'm in the mentor position. It's kind
of... Oh, goodness. What about you, Flip? What you been up to?
Not much, man. Fucking working, lifting weights, and running. Trying not to eat like a fat ass. That's pretty much it.
It's a hard thing to do sometimes, isn't it?
For sure.
Food's too fucking good.
Oh, food is fucking delicious, bro.
Me
personally, I've been doing the same, lifting weights with Flip, taking showers with Flip.
Come on, man. Come on.
Working and playing video. That's about it. Speaking of video, let's talk about Evo Flip. Because me and you be
about
the
to
only
say,
ones.
All right. I
would like to hear from the fighting game community, Toby. I don't know if you can speak for them.
The fighting game community.
Oh man, come on.
ZP hates us, by the way. Just so you know, he hates the FGC. He has a nice little shoot ready for us.
for when I mean, shit goes down. At least I hate communities that don't matter. Unlike Table, that hates like real communities with feelings.
Hey, Tumblr is not a community. Fuck them. But Evo this year.
What was your favorite shit?
Killer Instinct, man. I say surprisingly because last year I didn't even watch it because I didn't have an Expo and I never played the game. After getting an Expo and seeing how fun the game was, I watched the finals this year and they ended up being the most hype of the entire shit. Like, it was like the best. So, yeah, I couldn't believe like how good it was.
Yeah, I can kind of co-sign that shit. Like, while that shit was happening, I was messaging Tubby the entire time like, bitch, I gotta get a fucking Expo immediately and shit.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Shit. That's what I'm saying, man. Like, it's that game is really well done. I was blown away when I first played it. I played a free character download just to try it out for what the fuck. I wasn't expecting shit. I had Killer Instinct when it was fucking on the Super NES and N64. I believe it was on both those. But like, I was never huge in it. It was just a fun little distraction. But man, the game they've made now it's a contender up there in the fighting game community. It's really fucking fun and really well done.
Shut up, CP.
He was just waiting for that shit.
You ever know, you're like a football player, you know, in the NFL, like whenever they talk, they can't say like they threw the ball or they played the game. They have to say, yeah, it was a good football game. I threw the football. It's you have to say the fighting game community every time you fucking say it.
Why you hate on the FGC though?
It seems silly to me.
But like I said, it was surprising how good Killer Instinct was just to watch too. It was really fun. This dude named Rico Suave won, and it was great.
Oh shit!
I think then he could then win like a six round or six match game. Didn't he have to reset the brackets to win?
I'm about to say he was in losers finals and he had to reset the brackets and win that shit. If I remember correctly, that shit was ridiculous.
Yeah, for those of you who don't understand, if you basically best of losers, best of winners fight it out for the grand finals, the loser has to reset the brackets by winning three games.
And that dude did it?
Yeah, he did it and then went on to win three more. Won six games against this one dude. Just the fights were great. Just everything about it was just ridiculously good. It's the best thing to happen to the fighting game community. But, Marvel was always hype. It's never been not hype. Street Fighter was, it wasn't, not, I don't know. I didn't enjoy it as much this year as I did last year for the finals.
Because last year you were fucking all over that shit.
Yeah. What about you, Flip? What'd you think about
Street Fighter? I mean, Street Fighter, they didn't have any, you know, none of the old favorites were there, man. It was like, I think it was only like two Americans. Well, yeah, no, PR Raw was a favorite, but, you know, I had a feeling of dread that he was not going to fucking make it to, like, the finals or nothing, just top eight, and, you know, he did, and RIP to Balrog once again. I mean, Street Fighter, you know, after that point, it was kind of like, well, which Japanese dude is going to win it, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, you know, it kind of ended up being that. The Guilty Gear, I think it's pronounced Exerd or something. It's a fucking stupid name. But that fucking game had a hype-ass fucking top eight. They had a fucking situation where this one dude got up after, like, I think he was winning. It was like a, you know, best of three or whatever, and he won the second game. And I think it was tied 1-1. And he got up after the fucking second game and fucking started celebrating.
Yeah.
And the other fucking dude went right into the third game while he was still celebrating and fucked him up. It was hilarious and very petty.
He literally thought the match was over. He's sitting up there throwing his hands up in the air. The other guy starts the round just wailing on him, and then he gets up and starts dancing on him. Just, I don't know how you fuck up that bad, but it was hilarious to watch. Well, watch the rerun. I didn't get to actually watch the Guilty Gear Finals, but watching the replay on YouTube was great. What else was it? I was happy that in the finals for Street Fighter that not only Balrog was there, he's usually there, but Guile was there this year. That's my guy. So I usually don't see Guile in the top eight for Street Fighter.
Yeah, neither one of those lasted long, but shout out to Charge characters.
Yeah, they didn't make it all the way, but at least they were fucking there. That was hype for me. And when Guile got sent home, that was the last American player to be in the top eight. So with Guile dying, the U.S. died too. It was sad.
Yeah, it wasn't no Sleeping Giants Awaken in that shit.
No.
So what did you enjoy about Killer Instinct, Flip? Oh. What was your shit that you were just like, oh fuck, I gotta get a fucking bow now?
Dog, it just looked really fun. It's a beautiful looking game too, and you know, you can just see the fucking high level of skill that it takes. So of course in my mind I'm like, well, I'm never gonna be that fucking good, but you just fucking look at that shit and you can just appreciate how, because when that they first demoed that shit, when they were first bringing it back, I was like, oh, this shit looks like trash. And then like last year I watched it, and the top eight was hype, and you know, I enjoyed it. But this year it was like infinitely better for some reason, and yeah, it just made me really want to just fucking cop a system just for that game. So you know, that might happen somewhere in the near future. I don't know.
I hope it does, dude. That game, we need people to play with. People that play fighters regularly. Not to discredit you guys, I appreciate that you play with us.
I would like to give a shout out to Monk.
Yeah. R.I.P. Monk. He's installed and uninstalled that game, I think, three different times now because I make him so mad in that game.
You gotta stop making people rage, bro.
Well, I don't get it. I mean, it's not like I'm playing cheap or anything. I just, you know, it's...
You're not? Just, I don't know, bro. I saw that one fucking
video. Yeah, that was... Video. That was the proof of point.
I'm disappointed, personally, that is how you would treat people in your community.
You just don't know them, bro. You just don't know. Oh, shit. But yeah, that's pretty much it for Evo. Seems like me and Flip the only ones that cared.
I care tremendously. I turned it on for a second. And
I was gonna say, didn't you ask like where it was on? Did you watch some of it towards the end?
I did. I mean, I didn't know what the fuck's going on, but I mean, all I'm thinking while I'm watching it is fuck, because I try to comment on it, because I'm like, I just want to fucking like advertise our shit in the fucking comments, but you have to like pay to fucking
be able to
comment, you know? So I'm like, I just want to be able to fucking
watch.
I just want to be able to fucking like be able to fucking for us to comment on shit, and that way to get fucking like advertise
it. It was being played on Twitch, right?
Right. Yeah. To comment in the Twitch chat, you have to pay $12 to follow them.
What the fuck is wrong with people? And people do that.
They do. I don't.
Bunch
I have no
fuck ton of people.
Oh
I know
my god. Plan
to comment because the comments barely get seen anyway because it goes so damn fast. But yeah, but it's just a way of supporting.
Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, freaking yeah, it was hype. I almost missed it this year. I'm glad. What was it, Neg? Or no, it was actually EP posted about it in the forums. I'm surprised I almost fucking missed it again. I missed it the year before, and I was pissed off myself for missing it. Like I said, that's like my fucking Super Bowl, man. I look forward to that shit every year. I love that shit.
Yeah.
Y'all are so quiet about that. I can tell y'all really care.
I care tremendously.
Alright, let's talk about...
They need to put Dark Souls 2 in it next year.
Oh, shit. That game sold those hitboxes, man. I don't think the FGC would appreciate Dark Souls 2.
Bro, I'm making top 8 every year, son.
You're right?
I'm winning that shit.
You'd have to fucking wear a DC shirt.
Oh, well, of course. Team DC. BBC.
Come on, man.
It has to be a belly shirt like Bill wore in Bill and Ted.
Yes. Our midriff showing.
Oh, shit.
I'm not consenting to any of that.
Getting sponsored, boy. You got to do it today. take one
for the team, Flip.
Or take one with the team. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
Yeah, we moving on. Let's talk about let's talk about True Detective.
That's not how that fucking sounds.
I figured it wasn't, but you know, the next True Detective. Let's talk. You want to talk about just the True Detective in general? I'll talk about the recent episodes. What do y'all want to get into?
Talk about the recent episodes and how Flip and Table are very negative.
All right, well, I'll go first then. All right. There's two sides of this. The side of me that compares it to True Detective, the first season, it's not even in the same universe of quality. Like, they shouldn't even have the name True Detective on it when comparing it to the first season, in my opinion. They're not even close to each other. Well, not comparing it to True Detective, it's not a terrible show. It's more like a CSI show to me, though, right now, than anything actually interesting, like mysteries wise or any of that. So, I'm not a huge fan, but I don't hate it. But if I compare it to season one, I'm definitely is not even in the same league, close. Too many characters, in my opinion.
I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying the ride. I want to see where they're gonna take it since they fucking jumped it up, fucking 2 months and all this other shit's starting to happen. Spoiler alert! If you haven't seen it, don't fucking listen for like 10 minutes.
Well, yeah, the latest episode, which was episode 5, they've been like doing the most detective work that they've done the entire season.
Now that they're not detectives, they're detectives.
Yeah.
That's the best.
Actually, part. You know, two of them aren't anymore, but now Paul is an actual detective instead of just being a guy assigned.
Oh, we're referring to them as their character names now?
I mean, you can call him Taylor if you want.
So, yeah, but now they're all detectives again since they all got fucking put on that shit. So, since they're fucking... Okay, so here's my prediction. Since they're fucking... They're both looking for the hard drive because Vaughn needs it to fucking get his shit going. Farrell needs it to get the fucking kid back. And so they're going to end up fighting over the hard drive. Farrell's going to end up killing Vaughn. And then the fucking redhead's going to find out she's having Vaughn's baby.
Well, I'm pretty sure he's going to kill Vaughn anyway, just because of what we recently found out.
I feel like they're going to fucking be like, all right, well, my bad, dog. Yeah, it's all right. And they're going to fuck around. They're going to find the fucking hard drive, copy that bitch over to another hard drive. They both going to have a hard drive, and they both going to win because of the hard drive.
Nah, that's too happy of an ending.
No, that's going to work. Well, this is not True Detective, man. Like this nigga said, it's motherfucking...
It's CSI.
CSI or fucking New York Undercover. All right? This shit ain't no fucking...
I think you're just angry that there's a gay character in it, Flip. That's what I think.
I don't think I'm angry at that at all.
I think
the gay character has the hottest woman on the fucking show.
Paul Woodrow's going to kill all the other cops. Then Vince Vaughn is going to adopt the ginger kid off of Colin Farrell's ex-wife. Because he's okay with adopting now. And they're going to hold a funeral service for, you know, the most dearly departed member of the show, Colin Farrell's mustache.
Mustache. Oh my god, dog. That shit looks so strange, man. And then they gave him like a scar right there and shit. It's like, man, just I hope that shit just comes back in the next episode, bro. Oh wait, it's not because he's sitting at the fucking table.
I thought it was weird that they had that Leto guy's cousin come in and, like, scalp his upper lip. That was weird when they did that. Spoilers.
Already.
Yeah, you are.
That if you had just gone up and left and then come back without saying nothing, nobody would have known. Listen.
but you had to make this about you, which...
So the Offshore Detective right now, me and Flip are still kind of iffy about it. You guys are still pretty okay with it.
I mean, you're saying you're iffy, but man, there were some very harsh words.
This episode was solid.
Yeah, the episode was really good, but if you're comparing True Detective One, man, they're not even fucking in the same universe at all.
You knew they wouldn't be, though.
They hit
you
the
knew
highest
it wasn't
highs.
Gonna be.
Well, like, you can't, I mean,
yeah, you it's be sad that it's not. It's really sad that it's not. I mean, yeah, you just hoped they would be, you know, at least I did.
Well, it's like I was saying in the chat with you earlier. First season, it was 8 episodes, 60 minutes each, and it was just the fucking Marty and Cole show.
Yeah.
This is spread out between...
AKA the best show ever?
Well, yeah, but it was... This, now it's split between 4 different characters... And
none
there's so many more side characters than there were in the first season. On top of those main ones, and it's just... And plus, the writer guy, Nick Pizzolatto or whatever, like, this was a script he had written, and he just, like, he was trying to sell something else, and then he showed him this. So this is something, like, the season one, he had years probably to work on. And then that was a success, and now he's like, oh, I gotta write season two. So, I mean, this isn't even as refined. He hasn't as much time to think about it, I'm sure, as he did season one.
So you're saying he just kind of threw this one together?
Well, compared to the first one, where, like, he didn't write shit for TV or movies before that, yeah.
Right.
Well, like I said the other day, you know, it's... I don't know, we both agree on there's too many characters. And, honestly, I think they could... do away with Paul or whatever his name is.
Well, I'm not saying there's too many. It's just that with there being so many more, it's spread thin. You can't write as great, good shit.
But there's 8 episodes, 1 hour each, and there's 4 main characters. Come on, man. There should be... I mean, I like Vince Vaughn. I like Farrell's character. And Rachel McAdams' backstory makes her character interesting with the cult shit. But the other dude has nothing going for him. If they completely wrote him off, I would never bother me.
Right.
Yeah. There's nothing that he brings to the show, in my opinion. He could have been completely done away with. But yeah, I'm guessing they're saving something for him towards the end that I don't know
about. He's got to be like, right, he's going to have to be like the dude who killed Casper or something for me.
Yeah.
To give a fuck about
he's going to kill her the whole
You're
time
saying
or something.
That the reason he's lower on the totem pole than Bizzariti's chick is because he doesn't have a dad that runs a hippie commune? Like, that's literally the only thing she has going for her, is David Morse runs a fucking retard commune.
Yes.
Their characters are neck and neck to me for, like, least interesting, for sure. I don't know, they try to give him some fucking They try to give him some fucking development this up with, I guess, his mom stealing 20 grand from him. I don't know. I didn't give a fuck. He didn't seem like he was too broken
Flip.
About it.
Flip. He bled for that money.
Did he? I don't know, dude. It looked like he got, like, branded for that money or something like that. I don't know if too much blood was spilled.
Instantly cauterized. No blood.
She did carry him for 9 months, and he ruined her fucking career.
Fucking what a asshole. Career it was.
Yeah.
I was a dancer.
If only she was a man.
I think, honestly, I would just prefer, because basically, in my opinion, the show's only being carried by Vaughn and Farrell anyway. So if they just, if it was just them,
it was just
I wouldn't
them
mind
too,
that either. But, you know.
And Bill, isn't it Bill Pullman, the dude who's the father? The fucking.
Hey, Bill Pullman.
No, it's not Bill Pullman. I forget his name. Oh,
that's
he's
my
Irish
dude,
guy.
Man.
He's
with that dude.
Who Farrell's dad?
Come on, Fred Ward.
Fred Ward.
Yeah.
Who's been in David like Morse. 10 minutes of the show?
No, I don't care, man.
Hey, I like. I freaking loved Colin Farrell's dad. He was great. He's only been there a few minutes too.
That's who Fred Ward is.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about the Rachel McAdams dad.
If you were familiar with Tremors and Tremors 2.
I didn't watch Tremors or Tremors 2.
Well, McAdams' dad is David Morse.
Yeah, and he's been in tons of shit.
Yeah.
I'm fucking up all the names. Who the fuck is Bill Pullman? Let me look it up.
Bill Pullman's like fucking Lone Star.
Yeah.
The dad from Casper.
And he was also, yeah, exactly.
Holy shit. That's not him at all.
Right?
Oh, white people.
Wait a minute. You sneaky white man.
Exactly. Oh, shit, man.
You're not poor, man.
Not at all, man. But yeah. Oh,
that's great.
That guy that y'all said. The other one. Yeah, like, yeah. He was
how are you white dude looking like?
David Morse with the weird hair extensions.
Yeah, right? He does look fucking retarded as a hippie, but.
Yo, the hair is crazy, but. Fuck it, he's great.
Yeah.
Dude, doesn't the fucking little plastic surgeon / psychiatrist look a little bit like fucking Benedict Cumberbatch?
He does
a little bit. Yeah, I was actually looked it up to see if it was him, like
in the
sky
or something.
Him?
Yeah,
it's fucking Rick Springfield, yo.
Is it?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Jesse's girl, come on.
I thought Jesse's it kind of looked like Springfield girl. Too, with makeup on. Damn.
Well, he's definitely got a weird face.
He fucking does. Like, and I wonder if they, you know, made him look like that, or if he actually has had shitty plastic surgery himself.
I mean, that's L.A., though. It's 50-50.
So, yeah, that's True Detective, folks. All right. Flip, did you get a chance to watch the movie Creep on Netflix yet?
Sure didn't, buddy. The fuck is that?
Well, you had 2 weeks, Flip. Yeah, two
it's a Mark Duplass movie, and me and
I totally forgot that I was supposed to be doing anything else besides watch True Detective.
Right, True Detective is the only prerequisite for the show, but Creep is a new movie from. I don't think he's directing it, but he's in it, Mark Duplass. But actually, wasn't the guy who's the video camera guy, wasn't he the actual director and writer?
Yeah, he was
the
director, like Patrick Bryce, I think his name is.
Yeah. And he actually favored our tweets.
Yes, he did. him and Duplass kind of wrote it and plotted it out. Like, I don't know how much writing actually went into it, but they're both credited with the story.
That's nice.
And they just like went out to this cabin / house and I guess fucked around and came up with a plot and filmed it.
Yeah, which, by the way, was really good. I mean, but from somebody like me, it's not surprising. I haven't seen a bad movie with Duplass in it yet, which is pretty crazy because all he does is mainly indie shit and not
and his own
some
shit.
Terrible indie shit.
Yeah,
but everything that he does seems to be great. So,
I was scared. I fucking love the Duplass brothers, but like the trailer when I'd been wanting to see Creep for a long time. Then the trailer finally came out a few months ago, and it just did nothing for me. But then
I'm
actually watching
that.
The movie.
I liked the trailer, man. I was like, yeah. Oh, this is creepy. You know, like Well, and it ended up being, I mean, it lived up to his fucking name. It was creepy as fuck.
Yeah, fuck yeah, it was.
Mufasa did a perfect fucking creep, man. He really did well at that. I mean, it's just, you just have to see it, dude. I don't want to spoil anything or talk about what happens, but
yeah,
it was a really great fucking movie, and it's on Netflix, so there's no reason
not to watch
it. He's
as gentle as a rabbit.
Yeah.
Fucking Peach. Fucking Bill Pullman was the president in Independence Day.
Yes, he was.
By the way,
Adam Baldwin was one of his Secret Service bros
in
Independence Day.
Jesus.
Oh, that's great. By the way, Mr. Pullman. Oh, boy.
Oh, shit.
Oh, I love you nerds.
Yeah, so, but fucking...
The creep is it's the same as lots of other stories and even smoothies where a guy hires a guy.
Smoothies.
And then to like be with him, film him, because he's supposedly dying, and then it goes sideways.
Yeah, it takes a turn. Crazy.
But if you're a fan of Tubby, there is quite a bit of Tubby time in that film.
Yes. He actually does a call out to me because he loves DigitalConfederacy.com.
How can you not?
Yep.
With members like fucking Dig.
Fuck.
I don't know what that's supposed to mean.
Dig's a loyal listener, sir.
Fuck him.
No.
I know. Dig's pretty hot for an old dude.
I have nothing further.
So there's a picture of Springfield for you.
Do what?
So there's a picture of Rick Springfield for you.
Oh.
You realize that our listeners can't see that. It's very rude of
they
you.
Should Google Rick
describe
Springfield.
Him right now.
But yeah, he definitely doesn't look near as weird in that pictures they made him up in the fucking show, though. That shit was crazy.
Yeah, he definitely looks like he's all fucking, like, Botoxed up and shit.
He looks like the dude who was in the wheelchair in fucking Hannibal that got fed to the fucking pigs.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, fucking Gary Oldman.
Damn, that was fucking Gary Oldman?
Yeah.
Oh, you didn't know that was Gary Oldman? Really?
I mean, I don't really fucking have fond memories of the film.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, I love the film. I loved it even more in Hannibal when they redid it, but yeah. Yeah, that's right. That show Hannibal goes up to that point, and it's fucking great. I like it better than the actual movie itself. Cause you
then
get to
it
see
got
him.
Canceled.
Well, no, the season 3 is still going. Apparently, according to our boy Steve-O, it's kind of fallen into the True Detective season 2 trope where a whole lot of nothing's been going on for the past like 5 or 6 episodes. So I haven't checked it out yet to see that, but it's kind of odd because the first 2 seasons are fucking every episode something nuts is going on.
So NBC saw the writing on the wall?
Yeah, well, he said Steve's exact words were, oh fuck, we're getting canceled. He might as well just phone it in now.
Oh, no.
Damn.
But I'll
check it out.
They didn't
get canceled until like most of that shit was filmed, though.
Yes, I'm saying I gotta see though, because I don't know, I don't know how the quality could drop that much, you know, because Hannibal's got a consistent plot line, you know. It's not like True Detective where it's an anthology series where it's got starting over every fucking time. So for it to drop that much of quality would be something I have to see. To,
but
like,
it's not starting over every time.
Starting anew every time. Are you happy now?
No, it's really not. They got the animal mass sex cults. They got the Vince Vaughn is saying the same bullshit as Russ Cole, only like as Vince Vaughn.
Yeah, and Jews did 9/11. Anyway, no, but I see what you're saying, but
and
I don't know.
Blue balls in his heart.
Dog. I hate the fucking dialogue so much.
Dude. Vince Vaughn fucking delivering some of them lines, man. Just.
But that's the same kind of shit they were feeding McConaughey in season 1.
No, but it's like McConaughey's so spaced out and weird. You're like, okay, you can fucking.
Yeah, I buy it.
This motherfucker buys into that shit. Vince Vaughn is typically, you know, he's like one of the cooler dads in all the fucking old man comedies and shit.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, dude, I. Fuck. It's just. some of the shit he says, man, and the way he says it too, like, it's like he tries to do serious, but sometimes fails really fucking hard at it. But like when he's like, when he's like tough gangster Frank, like, you know, I'm gonna kick your ass Frank, like, I buy that shit. But his whole,
yo, domestic Frank is not what's up, son.
Yeah, I know. They do not need to give him any monologues of his wife anymore.
I appreciate that you did that, that you said that. When you said that, it meant something to me.
Exactly. Yeah, he just needs to keep being tough gangster Frank, you know.
Just punch motherfuckers in the teeth. Take the golds out and throw them away at the trash at home. And,
you know, say cool shit like, I never liked these things. How can you greet the world that way? You know, saying cool shit like that. You know, don't get him waxing philosophical with his wife, because that shit's terrible.
Yeah, man. You know, who loves who?
I don't get that. It's like they're trying to make him a well-rounded character, but Vince Vaughn can't pull off the well-rounded, so just let him be crazy Frank.
I was saying that at first. Like, him and Farrell obviously are doing all the heavy.
They're still the best, but I mean, I don't mean that he's doing good.
I like Vince Vaughn. I think he has capability of doing shit. Like, I like him, you know, not a comical character. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's doing that well. It's just, it's hard for me to buy into, like, they're not, you know,
I like apoplectic Vince Vaughn.
I don't know.
ZP loves that word.
That's a great fucking word.
I think he uses it every day. His word calendar has not changed since he learned that fucking
word. Only when I'm talking to you, though, because that's when I feel it the most.
I make ZP mad as fuck. And I don't mind.
Oh, man. Fucking Farrell's fucking killing it, though.
I mean,
we just keep having the same conversation. It's 10 minutes apart.
It's okay. When we edit it together, it'll fucking make sense.
I mean, I don't know. Fuck it, dog. True Detective's got 3 more episodes to not be, right now, just mediocre.
Yeah,
overall, that shit is just mediocre.
And it looks like they're starting the trend. I mean, last episode, they did that, so that some shit's coming together. So maybe they're finally going to lift the fucking rings off of it or something. But
we'll see. I mean, like, I predict that, you know, Vaughn and Farrell probably are both going to live to the end of the fucking show. So even though they both got, you know, their pussyfooting around under the table with their guns, I'm assuming that they're going to be fine. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He has to talk.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it's going to be. Then the redhead. Wait, so they moved into that fucking...
Yeah.
I don't know what the fuck that was. Yeah.
Money's tight. They moved into a smaller place.
They didn't need all that space.
They didn't.
With all the dead avocado trees.
Yo, he was mad about them fucking avocado trees, huh?
Because they reminded him of his wife's womb.
Come on, bro. That is not... I do not approve of that statement, guys.
Damn.
What if I have a barren wife one day?
And then
I'll buy you some guacamole.
And then that's even compounded.
All right.
That's even compounded when he tells the Mexican worker, I thought you people knew about these things.
Oh, shit.
You know about my wife's dead womb?
He's racist as
fuck, bro.
You know about my wife's dead womb?
Oh, man.
Well, she said it happened that way because of all the abortions she got, so, I mean...
She did get 3 of them.
Yeah, I mean... Pretty much asking for it at that point.
There were more than 3 abortions in Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
I feel like that shit should have repaired itself from 20 to whatever the fuck she is now, 43. I don't know what the fuck her character's supposed to be, but...
I mean, I think if it gets fucked up, it's gonna be fucked up. She's not Wolverine.
I don't know. It's, I mean, you know, I don't know. The human body, that should be healing all the time, bro.
All right, guys.
But yeah, Colin Farrell's killing it, though.
Moving on, let's talk about
Bill Pullman.
Apparently, Nosferatu director F.W. Murnau. Is that how you pronounce that?
I think so.
His head was reportedly stolen from the grave. why this is news or why somebody would do I don't know.
I added that in because I thought it was funny. I mean, the guy's been dead since 1931, and somebody just now decided, you know, let's steal that fucker's head.
Right.
Kick it around.
Not only do I get why the world should care, but why anybody would do it to begin with. They're both kind of mysteries to me. They both have maybe mysteries in True Detective right now.
Maybe they're Nosferatu fans.
Like, if it was like Max Schreck, the guy that played Nosferatu's head, that might make more sense.
Right.
Yeah, everybody thought he was a real vampire anyway, but it's director guy.
I need to watch that Willem Dafoe movie where it's based on him being a real vampire.
Oh, Shadow.
Oh, you
vampire.
Mean that docudrama?
Yeah. Yeah, I need to watch that.
It's real?
Oh, it's real?
Oh, yes.
I don't know whether to trust you or not, ZP. Something's telling me no.
They cast a real vampire. Why can't you believe that?
Oh, God. So why would you go around robbing old-ass graves? I mean, it's not like you can sell that shit on eBay. And I seriously doubt there's still a black market for it.
Hold on,
they said that there's candle wax around the grave, the tomb, so I think it was part of an occult ritual.
Oh, shit. Like I said, it's already better than True Detective 2. Let's go. Let's go. About time. Finally, we got some occult going on.
We should Rachel McAdams is going to be in the Eyes Wide Shut orgy this week, supposedly, so...
Who?
Oh, shit. Rachel McAdams.
There's an orgy at the end of this week or something?
That was, like, the big thing, like, in the off-season. They're talking about, there's going to be a giant orgy in this one. That's how you knew it was going to be not as good as the first season, because, like, the big selling point was, we're going to have a lot of porn stars in an orgy.
Why the fuck would they even... Why would you tell anybody about anything going on in the story? And B, why would that be the one you think you tell?
It wasn't the plot of the characters. It's like, you know, we're going to get a bunch of naked bodies fucking each other. It's going to be pretty great.
Is fucking Joe Ezrahouse?
It's like, yo, it's HBO. Let's make it, like, trash. Fuck, that hurts my soul that was actually hyped for the season.
I'd like to see Vince Vaughn doing some lifting in that, don't you?
I want to see Peach Fuzz.
I want to see more of Colin Farrell killing it.
You know what? Colin Farrell does that bolo tie good. That bolo tie, though. Seems how we're always rapping back to True Detective. Earlier today, I was thinking. I've been rewatching season one because it's fucking amazing, and I pick up new shit all the time, but. You know, I've been reading a lot about season two recently, and every time I read an article, there's always somebody talking about, like, how season one was great besides the disappointing ending. And, you know, they never give a reason why, really, and I'm just thinking, okay. So I thought about that. I was like, maybe they were disappointed because, you know, this is the end of Marty and Cole. This is the last time they're going to be... You don't get them anymore. Their story's done. But ZP apparently informed me that there was actually people who were pissed off that not only was it not Cthulhu who was doing everything, but that the serial killer was some backwoods redneck, and apparently what would be disappointed
not,
them.
Not like literally Cthulhu, but it wasn't like one of those type of monsters, otherworldly things going on. That it was just a redneck dude with multiple personalities.
So he kept it within bounds of reality to keep it legit, and people were mad about that. That's what I'm getting.
All these people were like buying the Yellow King book from the 1800s or some shit off of eBay and Amazon and reading all this like other shit that was influenced
the
show.
But do you know about Carcosa?
Yeah, exactly. They're reading all this shit, and then like when they realize they wasted all that money and time on shit that really doesn't have anything to do with the show, got all upset.
Well, see, what makes me mad about that is these are the type of people who fucking tell Stephen King it's okay to put a giant fucking spider at the end of fucking It. And it's okay to make that a story. These people enable this type of behavior, and that fucking pisses me off. So, yeah, they can go fuck themselves. If you're disappointed in the ending of True Detective for that reason, season one, yeah, you can fuck off.
Well, last time I checked, R.L. Stine's written, like, a few hundred books. What's Nick Pizzolatto written?
True Detective is all that matters.
He wrote a pretty decent book that I read, One Good Time.
I actually want to read some of Pizzolatto's book. He wrote a book called Galveston. And he wrote a couple other books, too. Or no, yeah. I have one other book sack, I think.
Short story collection. Galveston. It would make a good something show or series.
You read Galveston? It was good?
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, so I've actually got it on my Amazon wish list to check it out.
Is that book also about cops and criminals, or what's it about?
Yeah.
It's about a...
I was asking Flip who read it, not you, Table.
It's about a button man for, I guess, the mob or some shit like that. And I can't give you a fucking synopsis right now, but I just know it's not about cops and shit. So.
Well, Table, who didn't read it, says it was.
Table would be wrong in this instance.
I'm wrong!
I thought I remember reading synopsis about getting cops, but oh well. I know, apparently, a lot of people that reviewed it said it harkens back to McCarthy's earlier work, like Old Country for No Men and stuff, or No Country for Old Men and stuff like that. So that got me hyped to read it. So once I finish this Charlie Parker series, I'm probably going to check it out. But now that we're on books, Flip, you read pretty regularly, or is that like a one? What you reading right now?
Right now I'm reading something called The Showrunner's Bible, which is not something I'd recommend to anybody not trying to fucking write a series or learn more about the creation of fucking successful television series and shit.
So it's a self-help book, basically?
I guess so. Yeah, I guess we say it's educational material. You said what? Does it work?
I said word.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome. What about you, ZP? You read anything?
I'm reading the actual Bible, thank you very much. Any one of these knockoffs.
Is it better than True Detective Season 2?
No, I'm not reading anything right now. I've got a bunch of books that I need to read, but like I got the Phil Hartman biography. I got a bunch of shit, but nothing I'm actively reading right now.
Oh, yeah?
Stop bullshitting, bud.
Yeah.
I'm too busy trying to make forum themes to be able to read.
Right. Well, reading's how I actually get to sleep, because I used to lay in bed like awake at night just thinking about dumb shit and just couldn't shut off my brain. But Blasto's like, hey, read a book, man. You know, like, it'll actually put you to sleep. And he's not lying. But and then I got, and then Dig recommended me these Charlie
Don't
Parker
you mention
series.
That name.
But yeah, I mean, the series is so good. I went from none reader to I've burned through four of the books. I'm ready to start the fifth book now in a matter of months. So that's how good that series is. So I think there's like 13 books in the series. I imagine I'll be through with them all by Christmas. That's, and like I said, coming from a none reading position, that's a pretty big change. So yeah, that's how good that is. And then apparently I got my mom, my stepdad started on. Apparently they always read. And they recommended me some other detective style novels in that same vein. So I got a bunch of shit to read for a long time now.
So the one series that you're reading, how far, like how many books in are you?
I am about to start the fifth book, and I think there's like 12 or 13 so far in the series. And like I said, I literally started this book series,
like not that long ago. I mean,
yeah, it was. What was it? What are we in July now? I probably started it in May, maybe April. I think I started it in May. And, you know, I'm not a fast reader. Like, you know, I'm not a speed reader type guy. But yeah. I've been destroying through these books, man. Just, they're so good. Just, even when they try to put me asleep at night, like, I go through this thing where I fucking sleep read like two or three pages. And next time I read again, I got to go through the last two or three pages of my bookmark to reread and remember what fucking happened.
Right.
But, yeah, it's a really good series. John Connolly's the author. If you just want a good detective story to fucking crunch out, I definitely recommend that shit. All right. What about you guys? Have you been reading anything?
I only read digitalconfederacy.com.
The forums. There are good numbers.
You know what? I have been reading digitalconfederacy.com, and Colin Farrell's fucking killing it.
He had a great intro thread, and he's just, he can't fail.
He would show up on our site to promote that shit. But that fuck you, W, you're wrong. It's a great show. Check out my bolo tie.
I believe he has an Irish accent.
Yeah, we'll find out. We'll see what happens.
We'll see. We'll get to the bottom of this accent.
Alrighty.
It all sounds right. Alright.
Alright, moving on. Apparently, James Horner secretly wrote the score for Antoine Fuqua's Magnificent Seven.
Fuqua.
What, that's how you pronounce the name of this movie? Wait, the same way.
Say
here.
Say it again?
Yeah.
Antoine Fuqua?
Yeah.
No, I think that's accurate.
Well, yeah, see? ZP, in Houston, there's a fucking street called Fuqua, and that's how you fucking pronounce it. But for this, is Antoine
it's Fuqua.
Fuqua, yeah.
Yes,
yeah,
when I first moved here, I thought it was Fuqua, too. There was like, no, it's all Fuqua. It's all Fuqua.
Well, that's how you pronounce the fucking street name, but this guy's name is not pronounced like that. It's pronounced differently.
Yeah, I've heard both pronunciations when dealing with this guy.
Well, then those fucking people are wrong, Flip.
When were you dealing with this guy?
Say again?
When were you dealing with this guy?
I'm saying I've heard it pronounced
Yeah, in Houston, it's pronounced Fuqua, like,
Fuqua.
Full stop. Yeah, nobody says anything different. When I moved here,
we all gather Fuqua. Around and we talk about him and his films, and we all
Yeah, I always thought it would be Fuqua when I first moved here, but I was corrected, it was Fuqua.
Because I used to live by there, like, close by there. That's, like, where I grew up, like, right
I'll meet
there.
Them all.
Right there. Yeah, that's where I grew up, dude. Yep.
Explains a lot.
Exactly.
But yeah. About Antoine Fuqua.
Do it to hurt me.
I'm doing it to help you, Kiedel.
So, James Horner.
James Horner, the guy that recently died in a plane crash, because all those rich guys who go out flying planes by themselves always die in plane crashes. He scored... Fuqua's recent, or soon to be out, or already out by the time you hear this movie, Southpaw, for, like, nothing, just because he liked the movie. And then, before he died, he'd written the score for Magnificent Seven remake that Fuqua's doing, based solely on the script, which is bizarre, because nobody fucking does that. And then after he died, his, like, assistants brought the music to Antoine Fuqua. So it'll be interesting to see, like, what they actually end up using once the movie actually gets made.
Oh, he died today? Oh, shit.
He didn't die today. No, he died a while ago, a few weeks ago.
Or a month ago, sorry. It was June 22nd. I was looking at it, I was like, fuck. He died a month ago? Damn, that's crazy, because he's like, fucking... He's like Hans Zimmer level.
I don't know, if fucking Flip was worried about Zimmer...
We weren't even expecting Horner. What the fuck?
Zimmer lives on.
I think Zimmer fucking may be up to this. I think we need to investigate.
He has to feed off of James Horner's youth to stay alive.
Damn, he's a real life vampire dog.
So Horner scored Southpaw, and you recently saw that. What were your thoughts on Southpaw? Because I want to see that.
I thought it was really good. Yeah, I even liked Forrest Whitaker in it. And typically, Forrest Whitaker's hit or miss with me, but he was excellent.
Don't diss Forrest, though. Come on.
I'm not going to diss him, but like he's very hit or miss. But you know, that's probably to his credit because it makes you hate some of his characters because you're supposed to.
Right.
Like Glass King's Goblin.
Yeah. Like fucking Kavanaugh in The Shield.
Oh my god, so good.
He killed it in that, but man, I hate the fucker.
But Vic Mackey smashed his wife, though.
Oh yeah, Vic Mackey even more.
Mackey was pretty despicable. I don't know, dog. I hate Shane the most.
Honestly, I'd like Shane the most.
Dog, no, dog. After he did Lim that way, dog, no.
Dude, that episode literally made me, like, my stomach was all feeling sick. I was like, what the fuck? Shows and movies don't typically do that, but that one was like, whoa.
Bro, he thought it was just a sandwich. Not quite, bud. Not quite.
Your favorite.
That's fucking, and that's fucking Walton, right? That's who fucking Goggins
are. Goggins.
Yeah, bro. He looked sad dropping that shit off in the car, too. When he walked away, it was like, damn, dog. Feel the pain in his heart as he blows this motherfucker
He was doing
up.
What he thought Vic would do.
Vic probably would have done that shit.
And the hypocrite got all pissed off at Shane.
Well, you know those bald guys.
So yeah, Southpaw's a pretty great flick.
Is it like, I mean, is there anything new in the boxing genre? Or is it just a great
movie? It really doesn't. I mean, if you've seen the trailer, you know how it goes. He's a successful boxer. His wife gets killed.
So she can be on True Detective.
Yes. She didn't have her knives with her, so she got shot.
Oh my god, bro. In fucking episode 4, I was like, she's gonna be trying to use this knife and get fucked up.
So yeah, she dies. Boxer loses his fucking mind, loses all of his cash because 50 Cent is a piece of shit. And then he loses his daughter, and then he tries to get his shit back together. So it's you know, it's nothing really new. It's very predictable.
But it's just how it's done, I guess.
Does Gyllenhaal kill it?
Oh, he does, yeah. I mean, more and more, every time I see a movie with him, like, I'm like, why is he?
He's nice, though. Like,
yeah, he's got it. Gyllenhaal,
bro.
Oh, yeah.
He's
had it since Donnie Darko.
Shout out to
Nightcrawler.
Yeah,
I've been fucking...
Yeah, but I mean, Donnie Darko I saw, I liked, but then, you know, he was doing shit like The Day After Tomorrow and all that other bullshit.
Why would
then recently,
he was trying to
find
himself, bro.
Yeah.
He did, you know.
he killed it in Brokeback, too, though.
Zodiac.
Jarhead.
Brokeback, Jarhead.
Yo, he's been knocking him out of the park for a minute. He did. He also
fucking
did that
Prisoners.
What's that fucking movie when he was like a fucking vet?
Why would you watch
back?
The Day After Tomorrow, whatever, to begin with? I mean, you brought that
I didn't watch The Day After Tomorrow. But no. I mean, when you're doing that kind of, I ain't seen Prince of Persia. I know it's shit.
Right.
Dog, I'm sure it's amazing.
Somehow I don't believe that.
Yeah. So Gyllenhaal is fucking great. The movie was really good, and again, it could have gone too far in the sentimental area or anything like that, but it didn't, which was good.
Is it better than Mad Max?
No, I wouldn't say it's better than Mad Max.
Is it better than Interstellar?
You know what?
I
would watch it again before I'd watch Interstellar again, which I did. I've seen Interstellar now. I watched it the other weekend, so it's twice now. And it's a great movie, but it's not one that you're going to watch over and over.
No, I haven't seen it a second time, even though it like took my soul the first time I saw it. But
you guys were big on Sons of Anarchy, right?
I haven't finished season 7.
Until the last season.
Showrunner guy, yeah. Kurt Sutter, wrote Southpaw.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yes.
That's good.
Sons of Anarchy was a really great show, in my opinion, up until the last season. Could have just ended it at the season before the last season.
Yeah, right, exactly. The season 6 was so ridiculous.
Yeah.
Getting sidetracked, but yeah.
That doesn't happen.
I know, we're fucking up right now. We gotta get back to our usual self.
Alright. I need to take a piss break when you guys want to take over.
Speaking of Interstellar...
I'll be right back.
So scientists are like... almost a year since it's come out. They're... maybe not quite. Yeah, a little over half a year. They're like all over themselves about how great the science is in Interstellar, which... you know, I understand that they were going for realism as accurate as they could get, but it's funny to me because 60 years from now, everyone's going to be like, that movie was so full of shit. Now the shit that we know.
Right. There's no fucking way McConaughey could have really came out of that fucking library.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, they're talking about, you know, it's so accurate with the depiction of black holes, but we really don't know that.
Right. There's no fucking way to know. But, I mean, maybe it's just, you know, you show them that movie to spark imagination or something.
I think Ren and Stimpy, the video game for Super Nintendo, had accurate black holes.
I feel like they had more than one game, so you'll have to be specific.
I'm talking about the one where they went into a black hole.
I don't remember, bro. I think that one was co-op, I think. So anyway, but yeah, go ahead.
No, it's just funny how they're talking about how accurate the science is of something that... we really haven't explored. I mean, dudes 500 years ago thought their science was accurate as hell.
It wasn't,
I'm sorry. Didn't you hear? Pluto's not a planet.
It's fucking bullshit. Get the fuck out of here.
It has.
Did they ever explain that reasoning? I mean, I know they did, I just forget it now. What was the reasoning?
They arbitrarily said that it's too small and too far away or some shit. I don't get it.
aren't we the ones that classify planets? So how do we all of a sudden declassify a planet when we started the classification?
Motherfuckers just got bored. I don't know.
I think Neil Tyson was trying to fucking make a name for himself, and
this is how great.
Son, are you bashing Neil deGrasse Tyson, son?
This is how I'll do it. I'm going to start fucking with astronomy. I'm going to start fucking with all kinds of shit. I'll hang out with Bill Nye. He's going
to love me. Pluto's not a planet. Get kicked off the planet. So
you know what? I didn't watch Bill Nye. I watched Beekman's World, so fuck you.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Beekman's World was good, too.
I watched Bill Nye.
I watched Mr. Wizard on Nickelodeon.
No, yeah, I don't know. It's just arbitrary, I think. They decided that the classification was going to be one thing now, so buy Pluto.
Oh, goodness.
They need to sell tickets to the Science Museum in New York.
Yeah, yeah. I really don't get the declassification. It's like, it's all of a sudden like, oh, yeah, by the way, this is no longer a planet. It's like, were you wrong in the first place, or y'all just changed the structure of planetary concerns, or... I don't know, it's just like, all of a sudden out of nowhere, yo, you ain't a planet no more, babe. It's like you got a pink slip from the planetary.
The structure of planetary concern said that you are no longer a planet.
But yeah, but they fucking, they finally got something to fucking get all the way fucking out there and take pictures and shit, so that's fucking pretty cool.
Yeah, that is fucking awesome. That's one of the things, like, I wish we, like, devoted more money to is just space exploration.
Fucking years.
Which moon of which planet? They always talk about rains diamonds.
Oh, yeah.
Really? But like, they've never actually been there and taken any of this shit back.
Yeah, to be able to, yeah.
But they're like, they're looking at it from space, and they're like, this motherfucker's raining diamonds. It's like, really?
You know, Israel's building a spaceship right now.
People used to blow their minds over moon rocks. If they would actually go and bring back, you know, space diamonds, I
think we could get Bush to invade them.
We could fund NASA forever.
Saturn, it's a Saturn and Jupiter, both the shit rains diamonds.
Hell yeah, that's crazy, man.
It took that fucking thing to get out to Pluto.
Just orbit around
years.
It with a fishing net. Yeah. Like, look what I got.
9 years, and it used to be our ninth planet.
Yeah. And that shit's fucking crazy.
So, if like we ever actually get to go like visit planets and shit, apparently like if you go to Pluto, you don't need to buy like a card, like, you don't need to buy like I visited Pluto card because nobody gets like, oh, you're not a real planet.
You get Pluto in addition to like going to fucking like Saturn or something.
Yeah, Pluto's just the ugly stepsister nobody gives a fuck about anymore.
You can go there if you want to; it's included with the membership.
The one hooker who never gets picked out of the lineup.
That's Pluto. You went to a planetoid. Yeah, I went to a real planet. So,
yeah, it's hilarious. Like, yeah, no, sorry, brother. You just, no, it's not. Yeah, that don't count. That's just sad, man.
Yeah.
The Stonewall Jackson 5.
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 Alright, let's talk about video games for a little bit. What are you guys looking forward to coming out? I'll go with you, Levi. What are you looking forward to, baby?
I have no idea when it's coming out still, but No Man's Sky.
Yes.
Looking forward to that. I just realized the other day that Cuphead doesn't come out for a fucking year, so that's disappointing.
Disappointing, but unsurprising.
Right?
A year ago I would have said Fable Legends, but the beta really hasn't done shit for me.
Oh.
I don't think I'm supposed to say that because of disclosure agreements and shit, but...
By the time this episode comes out, that'll be done.
I'm going to get it because it's free to play. I'm sure I'm going to dump money into it because I want to buy the characters. But so far, and the beta is just such a small scale version of the shit that's going to be in it. But yeah, it's just doesn't do much for me. But Fallout, I've got that shit pre-ordered.
Nice. Oh, yeah.
I want to get Mad Max. I want to get Metal Gear Solid. There's actually a lot of shit I want to get.
You should get Mad Max. All I've seen so far is car combat. I mean, is that all it's going to be?
You haven't watched anything then, because, yeah, they showed him outside of the fucking car.
Well, yeah, like the little bit I've seen outside of the car seems like barren wasteland, like, worse than New Vegas, like, barren
wasteland. I thought you loved New Vegas.
I do love New Vegas, but, I mean, so when you were out in the actual desert part, it got pretty empty and nothing out there sometimes.
I think this is going to be a True Detective 1, True Detective 2 thing if you're comparing the two.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not trying to compare it to Fallout. I'm just saying when I watched it, it just looked like when he was actually out of the car, there wasn't a whole lot going on there worthwhile. But I could be wrong. I haven't played it. Just what I watched so far.
Well, it's the same guys that did Just Cause. And I've played Just Cause 2. That's the only one I played.
Oh, I hated that one.
I didn't like it. I didn't finish it. But that gameplay and that game, those guys, if they had a theme that I gave a shit about, which would be Mad Max, I think they could make a good game that I would enjoy. Just Cause nice. 2, if it was like a different theme, I'd probably like it a whole lot more than I did.
Hell yeah.
As it was, my favorite part was going to the Lost Island that they had.
Yeah, I rented Just Cause 2 because all the hype about it being so good and everything, but it got so boring for me. I mean, it's like, I didn't like the controls at all. But if Mad Max, like you said, is a good theme, and the controls are good, I plan on checking it out anyway. From what I've seen so far, I was just like, it doesn't look too stellar. I'm not going to buy it. I'll definitely gamefly it, though. What about you, Kaiser? What games are you looking forward to?
Let's see. I'm just fucking waiting for Blops 3 to come out. That'll keep me busy for a little while. I'm trying to think of some other shit. Like, I haven't really seen... Like, Mad Max looks kind of cool. I can't think what else. Everybody's all fucking on Fallout 4. And... Even though, according to everyone, the footage of it looked terrible.
What? Now you trolling.
And the frame rates and the animation. Oh my god, it was the ugliest fucking game I've ever seen.
Right. Yeah, that... Dude, I don't... I've been replaying New Vegas on 360, and it's pretty much the ugliest of the Fallouts. I mean, Fallout 3 looks way better than New Vegas. And even on 360, it's still a fine-looking game. Because I've been playing Fallout 3 on PC with no mods, but it's just gorgeous, even without mods. And it's like, I don't get the hate. And then people are saying that this one looks just like that. I'm like, the world's
yeah,
a difference. It's ridiculously different.
People having opinions just to have them, like, I'm gonna be difficult.
What about you, Flip? What you looking forward to?
This indie game called Galaxy. I think it's called The Dimensional, some shit like that. It's based on like, it's like a roguelike based on those old fucking like Robotech, and well, not based on, but inspired by those old school animes and cartoons and shit. So that's coming out on PS4 next month, I think. Obviously, Dark Souls 3, whenever that drops. Everything y'all pretty much covered. You know, Fallout 4. I'll probably give Mad Max a look if I get, you know, if I get enough good praise from ZP.
He's praised the X-Bone a lot. You haven't bought one yet.
Oh shit, he doesn't have a fucking X-Bone, I thought.
No, I said he's praised the X-Bone a lot. You don't have one yet.
Oh well, yeah, that's like, you know, $300 or $400 as opposed to $60, so it's a little bit steeper. Street Fighter V, which I need to fucking enter the damn,
I was gonna say, did you play the video yet?
No, I fucking forgot.
Oh my god.
After I told you,
you're my feedback. Probably, what the fuck?
I don't think it's available until tomorrow. So, like, okay. I can enter the code today, but it's not available until tomorrow. Let's see. Excuse me. That's probably about it. I mean, y'all have covered most of the high profile shit.
I forgot to mention, I'm definitely going to probably get Hable. Not fucking Hable.
Fable.
I mentioned fucking Fable. I mixed Halo and Fable together. Fuck. Yeah, I'm gonna be getting the Halo. I'm fairly certain.
I hope Derek buys Halo, because there's no way in fucking hell I'm buying this. So I guess that leads off of my turn. Obviously Dark Souls 3, but that's a ways away. The Bloodborne DLC that's supposedly rumored are coming out. I'm looking forward to that shit.
Gotta beat that game one day.
What is it? I'm also looking forward to, of course, fucking Blops 3. That's gonna be fucking amazing, because Treyarch is always amazing.
But what system are you gonna get it on?
I'm actually planning on getting on both. I've already got the Digital Deluxe Edition on fucking Xbox. I'm gonna save it and probably get on PS4 too, because there's gonna be tons of players on both ends. I mean, people can show up for the Treyarch Call of Duties. Like, the pre-orders are, like, people are doing videos on how high the pre-orders are compared to the past couple Call of Duties. It's just, like I said, Treyarch is the face of Call of Duty now. Infinity Ward has been shit for a long goddamn time. People realize that. And Treyarch's now taking the helm, which is funny because I didn't play Call of Duty that much back in the day, but apparently Treyarch used to be the joke of the series. And Infinity Ward were the gods, but that shit's turned completely around.
Yeah.
I mean, it's everything I've seen of it. They stole a lot of shit from Titanfall, and that's fine because Titanfall's fucking amazing.
It's fucking.
So everything they stole from Titanfall was good, and then it's got the Treyarch shit on top of it. So I'm really hyped for that game. I'm kind of considering checking out Rainbow Six, but I don't know because as far as shooters go, man, between, you know, we've already got Hardline, which is a fucking amazing game. You know, the DLC's coming out for that shit. Every time DLC comes out for that, I'm just hoping. I was on the boards the other day for Hardline, and I was one of the people that were agreeing that I wish that, even though I've already paid my $50 for the premium, I wish they released the DLC for free so more people would come play.
Right.
Because, apparently there's a lot of people who don't like Hardline because it's not like regular Battlefield, which is one of the reasons I love Hardline, and
right,
they don't want to give it a chance for that reason. And if, you know, if releasing the DLC that I already paid for free to people to get a play, you know, it's fine, because at the point it's going, if people keep losing interest, I spent $50 on maps that I won't be able to play because nobody's going to be playing them.
Right.
So if they give them away for free, at least I'll be able to play them. But yeah, Hardline is just, I really wish people would give it a chance. It's so fucking fun. So between that and fucking Blops, I got my fucking first person shooters covered like crazy. That's why I don't give a shit about Halo, because in my honest opinion, it looks like the multiplayer looks like fucking Advanced Warfare. Bueno.
Yeah.
And
why would you buy that when you could buy fucking Gears?
Exactly. Oh, thank you for that. How the fuck did I forget about Gears? Gears of War.
You're welcome.
One. Yeah, thank you. The Gears of War 1 remake. Oh my god, dude. That'll probably be like between that and Hardline.
What?
Like,
there's going to be a remake?
Yeah, it comes out August 25th. I was in the beta. It was so fucking good. Fucking Gears of War 1's coming out August 25th. That's definitely high on the priority list. That's going to be played a shit ton. So yeah, I'm definitely ready for that shit. That between that and Hardline, man, my shooters are covered. Fallout's gonna be my RPG. I got the fucking Pip-Boy edition of Fallout 4, so I got
Jesus,
the disc version.
Even
though I prefer, but it's the funny part. I never get collector's edition. I didn't even get a collector's edition of Bloodborne, man. Like, and you know how much I love Souls, but that fucking Pip, that's how much I love Fallout, man. Like, that fucking Pip-Boy, I was like, I got the money, I gotta get it. I need that Pip-Boy. And that's what got me to start replaying all the Fallouts again, and I've just been having a fucking blast playing fucking New Vegas DLC and stuff, man.
I'm gonna slide my fucking cell phone into that Pip-Boy at least once.
Yeah, exactly. I'm glad I got an old school, I still got my Galaxy S3 that I use as an MP3 player now, and that apparently fits in the old Pip-Boy, or the Pip-Boy anyway, because apparently the newer phones are too big, like the S6 and the iPhone 6 and shit, they're too big for it. So my older phones will fit fine. And yeah, I'm definitely gonna fucking put that on at least one time, like a fucking nerd.
Are those fucking editions sold out? They gotta be by now.
They've been sold out twice over. Watch out for them again. But yeah, they've been open twice over. They've been sold out.
I don't think I'll fucking like the fucking. I got the fucking Arkham Knight collector's edition with the statue and shit. That statue is fucking plastic and shit. I thought it was going to be fucking...
I'm sorry.
I thought that shit was going to be like pewter or something, dog. That shit is fucking cool.
You went the monk route. I'm sorry.
is that something he did as well? I don't know.
He probably did if he could.
More likely.
But no, like, Fallout's like a... Like I said, I'm playing the DLC now because I never got a chance to play through it back in the day because I never bought it. And then I got the New Vegas edition from Blue, who gave it to me for free. And I fucking just never got around to playing it. But, dude, like, this gives me hope that I'm hoping that Bethesda and Obsidian will come together again so that we get Fallout 4 from Bethesda and then we get a spinoff again by Obsidian because Obsidian's writing for Fallout is unmatched. I mean, if you go on our digitalconfederacy.com forums into our Fallout thread and you look at the video I posted of the dialogue between you and one of the monitors in the New Vegas DLC, you will not find a single character in Fallout 3 that you could talk to for 15 minutes and be fucking entertained the whole fucking time. It's just not possible in a Bethesda game. Skyrim, fucking Oblivion, Fallout 3, none of them are that fucking interesting. And, like, this is just one of the fucking 8 monitors in the DLC, and it's just fucking hilarious.
Well,
the whole
in Skyrim,
time.
It's a fucking requirement to skip all the dialogue.
Right? In most RPGs, for me, it's a requirement to skip the actual, like, interpersonal dialogue. I read it and then skip what they're saying, but this time I didn't skip shit, man. I let that dude talk and it was just fucking great. The line delivery, the writing, everything was just fucking hilarious. I was amazed.
You talking about New Vegas?
Yeah, New Vegas. DLC New Vegas. Old World Blues, man.
Yeah, I need a fucking, because I got that shit for the Steam Summer Sale. Because I only played, like, for a certain amount of time. Like, right up until the point where I got the fucking gun from Blade Runner. And then I, like, stopped. But, I'm going to fuck with it.
I'm actually going to create a new pair. Because I got the Ultimate Editions on PC as well through Steam. So I'm going to create new characters. I already created one. A girl on Fallout 3 called Two Bay. And, she will continue her quest in New Vegas. It's just Fallout, man. It's just a game you can get fucking lost in. New Vegas, even, like I said, it's the ugliest of the Fallout series. And it's still just fun as hell. And it still looks great. It holds up well. And, like I said, the DLC's fucking, 4 years old now? I think the game came out in 2010. So it's amazing that it's still this good. And I knew so much about it even going into it. It was still just some cool shit happening that I wasn't expecting. So, yeah, it's Fallout 4 is a no-brainer. And I really hope that fucking Bethesda and Obsidian partner up again because I would love to see another Obsidian spin out on the new Fallout engine. Because if you notice in Fallout 4, our character now has a story. Like, he's actually spoken dialogue. So he's not going to be a nameless wonder Gordon Freeman type guy.
I don't know if I like that.
You know what else he has?
What's that?
A dog.
He's always had a dog. God, you and them dogs. But that shit doesn't bother me actually because if their writing is on par, then I'm all for it. You know, if that's what kind of makes me more excited about Fallout 4 actually. They're actually, if you've played any Bethesda game RPG, they never give their characters a fucking voice because I think they know their writing is shit. I think they understand that nobody's going to really give two shits about the story as far as the character's concerned, the main character that you play. So I think this time they're actually investing in a voice actor for the character and they want you to play a specific storyline with them. I think that maybe they've beefed up their writing chops, or at least they hope to have. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they did with that. But even if it's terrible, you still got the fucking wasteland to explore, so I'm not bothered by it at all. That was a whole lot of fucking shit.
I just like that the fact that in Tubby Time, 4 years ago, is 2010.
Kiedel time.
Holy shit, that's 7 years ago, isn't it? Wow. Man, that's how old fucking New Vegas is? Wow.
That's crazy. Also not right.
My bad, it's fine. This rebel yell is pretty good. I stand by this Rebel Yell whiskey. Oh shit. Dear Lord, what the fuck? Why am I adding? I'm adding two to every number and like thinking, like, I'm adding like, to get to 12 and thinking that, like, wow.
That's right up there with Kale, dog.
In my mind, I'm thinking, like, okay, 2010 plus to get you 2012, and now we're 2017.
No. What's wrong with your boy, Z?
Holy shit.
Oh, shit. Oh, that's fucking hilarious. That's fucking great.
Oh.
Rebel Yell Whiskey, we'll make you for shit.
Fuck up your calculator.
Hope you don't like math.
Don't ever drink Rebel Yell, an engineer. Holy shit, yeah, that's pretty terrible. Oh. Yeah, those are my video game shits. Fucking Gears of War is gonna be fucking amazing. That's this year's fucking Three sold me on X-Bone, dude. They have so much good shit coming out. Even for somebody who doesn't give a fuck about the next Halo, they got so much good shit coming out. You know, PS4 for me has got my, you know, the No Man's Sky, which I don't know when it's even launching, and it's got Street Fighter 4, but that's really all. Street Fighter 5. Yeah, that's all I really care about, though. I mean, anything else in the Bloodborne DLC?
The tables are fucking turned, bro.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. Like,
PS4 is kind of like they, I don't know, though. Like, Drive Club was trash. Motherfucking Uncharted got pushed to 2016. There's no new God of War coming this year. PlayStation 4 exclusives are dick, except for Bloodborne, basically. And we'll see about Street Fighter 5.
That's what I've been saying, dude. Like, fucking, it's unreal. Like, because I love the system at its core, but the games, man, they're not there right now. Unless you, like, you know, unless you're, like, hype about Final Fantasy and the what's that other game? Fucking, the Last Legend or whatever.
The Last Guardian.
Last Guardian, yeah.
Yeah, like, unless you like, you know, I'm a person who don't care about that type of shit. Unless you like that shit, man, you're fucking, on PS4, you ain't got much to look forward to. And even those are how far away? So is this like, I don't get, like, Sony, I mean, you know, they fucking, you know, 2013 the Xbox One was a piece of shit that came out to the world and everybody shit on, rightfully so, but 2015, the Xbox One ain't fucking around no more.
2015, that's like 3 years ago.
Goddamn, is he fucking... Oh. No, like, yeah, ever since Phil Spencer, the Jesus of X-Bone, took over, man, like, X-Bone's been kicking it into fucking gear, and, like, it's amazing. I play my X-Bone more than I play my fucking PS4, just because...
Bro,
I
just
mean,
say that you've betrayed PlayStation, bro.
But I actually still prefer,
you giving the pussy up to fucking Xbox.
But they got no fucking game.
You're giving the pussy up, dog. That's it. You're a hoe.
I wish, I don't know if there's a count, if there's an hour counter on your fucking systems, but I've owned my PS4 way longer on my Xbox, but I guarantee I probably got more hours on my Xbox.
I think we can settle which system you truly like. Mormon, you say you prefer the PlayStation, but the games are on the X-Bone. What system did you get Fallout for?
X-Bone.
Oh my fucking god.
that's multi-platform.
Well, see, X-Bone comes with the mod.
That's it, dog. That's it. No. We dead to me. That's a wrap.
X-Bone comes with the mods, man.
You don't want to play mods anyway. They ruin the game. Just ask Gravy.
You know what? I'm gonna challenge you, Gravy. I love you, man, but I don't get how you can be bogged down with mods, you know, just in that, how that obscures your playtime, baby. Just don't install them all. You ain't gotta. I play Fallout 3 without any mods.
Oh, yeah. Fuck. I forgot about one game that is coming out, like, very soon that I need to get, and that's the Rare Retro fucking remix, whatever the fuck it is.
Yeah, that shit's gonna be crazy.
I mean, yeah, it's just old games, but it's a must have.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that as well. I don't even honestly know what 30 games Rare even fucking made, but I know Rare made a lot of good games, at least back in the 64 era, so for those alone.
They made fucking GoldenEye, motherfucking Conker's Bad Fur Day.
Yeah, it's got the real version of Conker.
Yeah, like, dog, that fucking Xbox remake was so fucking terrible.
Oh, I hated it.
I didn't play it, Yes, I don't know. I don't have a frame of reference for that. I didn't play it on the N64, and I didn't play the remake, so I don't have a frame of reference. Ooh. But
you didn't play it on 64?
No, nah, man. I was too deep in Wayne Gretzky 3D Hockey and Mario. Man.
God, this can't have been during your Paco Jean phase.
I mean, I was wearing Adidas with an ICP hat and a Wu-Tang charm, but I was wrecking the 3D
hockey.
Oh,
my God. Oh, shit.
Well, man, you're gonna like Conker's Bad Fur Day because it also has a lot of '90s references. So,
yes. Oh my God,
I always heard good things. I remember when they were announcing it for the Xbox or whatever remake it was that, but people started shitting on it, so I didn't even look it twice at it. So yeah,
they censored it. They made the graphics all fuzzy, and the multiplayer
was poo, dog.
Yeah, they got rid of all the multiplayer from the original and then had this online bullshit.
Wow, really? What the fuck? Why?
Yeah, I don't know, dog. The essence was gone.
That just don't make any sense, but okay. I was saying, like, it makes you wonder, like, has Phil Spencer been, like, the fucking, what was it? Remember when Batman got fucking his back broken by Bane? And fucking all of a sudden, like, Azrael took over Batman and became, like, super crazy retard Batman.
Oh, boy, do I ever.
For some reason, I feel like I'm channeling your brother right now.
Fucking Azrael took over as crazy Batman. What the fuck?
I feel like I'm channeling Joey. Joey's with me right now. But,
yeah, Joey's a Marvel kid, sir.
He knows better. But no, just like it's like Phil Spencer was almost like I haven't checked where he came from, but like what he's been doing for Xbox should like be like written down somewhere, dude. Because the dude like everything Matrick did when he went over to Zynga. He's the one that tried all the stupid shit, right? Or at least they blamed it on him. And he went over to fucking Zynga, and they fired him from fucking Zynga, which is like Facebook fucking, you know, cheap shit game. So if you get fired from Zynga, you got to be fucking up bad. But
yeah, but I mean, Phil Spencer was the guy. He was the star of that video that was TV sports TV dog.
I'm saying like I don't know his full history on that, so I don't know like what, like ever since he's taken over at least though, man. Like I don't know he's like. He's trying his fucking best to get X-Bones in the good graces of gamers. he's not fucking pulling any punches anymore. That's what, you know, it makes me, like, it feels like Sony's almost underestimating them or has been underestimating them because they need to get their games on shelf, man.
Hey, bro. Hey. Chill out, Tubby.
The thing is, you can't even trust Sony to do that properly because they had one Twisted Metal game for the PS3 and it was shit.
What, are you saying Twisted Metal Black was shit?
No, that's on the PS2. That was, you know, four years ago.
Okay.
Not two months.
One. I didn't play the last one. The
Twisted Metal Black and Twisted Metal 2 are my favorites in the series. But
I love Twisted Metal Black.
Agreed.
But no, the one for PS3, I think it was just called Twisted Metal. Fuck that game.
I don't know. Like, I know some people that liked it, but
they stripped it of all the personality. You were like just playing generic dudes driving like themed. I don't know. It was stupid.
Why though? That's what. Like...
As long as they got Mr. Grimm and Sweet Tooth, bro.
Right?
They didn't.
What? Mr. Grimm, man, with his little sidecar.
You were driving as like fans of the other racers.
Never mind. Don't.
Yeah. What the fuck?
Destroyed. What?
And Joffy was behind this.
I think Sweet Tooth was there as like a character you fight eventually.
Your coach.
Yeah. Some shit. But yeah, you're just playing as like fanatics of the other rest of the other racers.
Wow. That's depressing. Fucking insane.
I don't want to know anymore.
Why would they do it like that? I mean, that makes no fucking sense. Money.
Because like most companies, they're like, we know what you really want, guys. This is what you really want.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, though.
I mean, but why would Joffy back that shit? I mean, those are his fucking characters, right? I mean, he's basically probably, the head of Twisted Metal, right?
He sucks at the Sony cock. That guy is all about that Sony dick.
Yeah, true. I mean, but still.
I mean,
he still
brought us God of War 1, and don't forget God of War 2.
I've never played a God of War game.
I hated God of War, personally.
Yeah, I played a demo, and it wasn't. It didn't do nothing for me.
Yeah, now that I would suggest playing it. Tubby says.
well, I thought the character was a bitch to begin with, because, like, didn't, like, he, like, he killed his own family and stuff, and then, like, he's, like, bitching at the gods about it?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much it in a nutshell.
I thought the story was, like, they brainwashed him or some shit.
Yeah, it was, I mean, yeah.
And then he banged a bunch of chicks in a hot tub.
How dare you make me do what I did?
I mean, yeah, nah, they fucking, like, Ares. I'm not going to fucking tell you the story of God of War right now. All right?
Well, I don't know, I'm asking.
No, go fucking watch the fucking YouTube of all the fucking cinematics, all right, bro?
You want I'm surprised he's 12 years old, according to
this. As much YouTube as Table watches, I'm surprised you ain't seen them shits already twice.
I said, then I'll be 12 years old, according to you, Zeno. 12 years old, watching the YouTubes.
Gotta watch your favorite YouTubers.
Oh, my God.
But yeah, like, no, I couldn't. I played God of War, I think it was two or. Yeah, I think it was two. I just could not get into it at all. Like, I'm not. I don't like QTE shit a lot. It had way too much QTE. So yeah. Yeah, quick time events for non nerds.
I'll
come on, bro.
You're going to explain that, but not BBC. That's nice.
I want people to Google BBC, especially the image section.
On that fucking article.
Can they get a bunch of pictures of Sherlock?
Mr. Holmes.
On that fucking Interstellar article, at the very bottom of it, it said, read more at BBC.
Let me tell Grunge.
As you will.
It's a great place for you to visit.
Just...
All right, so you guys, anything else to add to video games? I think we covered them all.
Thanks. The South Park game. I gotta get the new South Park game.
Oh, there's a new one coming?
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, here's my thing.
I didn't give Stick of Truth enough time.
I bought the first one, but I ended up just giving it to Blasto because I knew I was gonna have time to put into it. Because, and that's a testament to the game. That's not a detraction. They put a lot of shit in that game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It was just. I knew that from the get-go, I was like, I'm not going to have enough time to actually play through this game and enjoy it like I should be, so I sent it to Blasto so he could do it. But that's a testament to the game. It's like, that's how much shit they put. I mean, like, I spent, like, I think 2 hours, and I barely got into, like, the first, like, 2% of the fucking story.
Well, and after I beat the game, I immediately played it over again doing other shit. They fucking knocked it out of the park.
Yeah, if you want a time intensive with a lot of content RPG, fucking that game is the way to go. I just did not have the time to invest in that shit.
It's not super long by any means, but if you get into it, which you should,
right,
you're gonna be having fun.
Yeah, exactly. It's one of those games. Like, if I ever become unemployed, I'm gonna pick up because it felt like it was gonna be at least 100-hour RPG for me, and it was just.
It ain't gonna be anywhere near 100 hours. Don't worry about that.
But yeah, so the second one I probably won't get, but not because it's a bad game, because I know I won't put the time into it to play it. But if you like those type of games, I can go ahead and tell you the first one's fucking great. Like I said, the content's all there. And then if it's anything like the first one, then you should definitely.
If you like the show
one.
At all.
Yes,
it's a must.
Oh, the jokes are the fucking first 2 or 3 hours I played. The jokes are fucking hilarious, dude. That's like I said, they put a whole. You could tell like the people that liked the show and made the show like they fucking put their heart into that show, the fucking game. It wasn't some fucking trashy spinoff. It was
South Park 64.
I never played that. I heard it got a lot of hate for it, but I never played it, so I don't know.
I played it at a church lock-in.
Well, that's the place to play it. But nah, y'all fucking played the wrong South Park game. You gotta play that fucking Chef's Love Shack. That shit was tremendous.
Chef's Love Shack, eh?
Yeah, on 64, bro.
Was that the one that was like a party game or what?
Yeah, it was like fucking, it was like Mario Party, but like South Park. A lot of fun when you're like 12.
And you gotta take a break from YouTube.
Yeah, well, you were 12, what, 7 years ago?
Why you hating me?
Oh, 7 years.
That's a trick question. I know why.
So good.
Oh, man.
Oh. So if that's it for video games, I think we should get on to listener questions.
Oh, yeah.
All right. I'm going to go with me first because I like mine.
No.
No.
That's my answer.
No. I need to link it in chat, though, so Flip can get it. All right. The question is, would you for this?
What, are you assuming that I couldn't have clicked the Facebook link? Is that what you're...
Okay, you're like, okay. Yeah, so click that, and the answer is, would you?
I feel like you're trying to get us in trouble with this question, but yeah, definitely no.
Yo, are you fucking kidding me? Of course not. Why did this even enter your mind as a possibility? That it might work right away? What the fuck is wrong with you?
The titties, though.
I didn't get far enough to see that. First off, the fucking name is right there.
No, go to the pages, man. Look at them titties.
Bitch, I ain't looking at none of that shit. Look the at first picture was man. Enough. Nope.
Don't be afraid, Flip. Don't be afraid.
Y'all gotta chill, dog.
Alright, so Flip is giving his response, Kaiser.
No.
And ZP, you said no, right?
I most certainly did.
I'd let it blow me.
Tubby definitely is giving us some thought.
Yeah, he's let it blow me. I mean, when it's down there sucking your dick, you just see the tits flop right, out. I mean, all right. that's all you need.
Come on, bro.
I don't care if his name Darnell Thomas.
Don't say the name.
You gotta omit that shit. Man.
People gotta go on.
Trust me, he loves the attention.
Oh, you've spoken to him before.
No, I've just read the comments.
That Tommy wrote on the page.
I was about to say, you spent a lot of time on his page.
I just found this like earlier this week, but I was like, you know what?
Yeah, okay.
No, I did see the mutual friends, and Abel was on it.
Oh, no, we're not friends, but I definitely follow it now because it pops any other titties out. So.
Come on.
I'm just waiting for that up.
I mean, that you know, that's an impressive rack, even though it's a dude. That's an impressive rack. I mean, you gotta be impressed with that, dude. If you didn't see the name and it had a wig on, you wouldn't know.
Oh, table.
Motherfucker, who wouldn't know? There's nothing feminine about that fucking face.
Look through the pictures, man. You see the feminine.
I'm good, dog. This motherfucker said if it had on a wig, you wouldn't know. No. This dude is crazy, man.
I can't believe it's not butter.
Oh, man. Thank God Colin Farrell was killing it, boy.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, tell me not allowed to put no more questions in that shit. Right? Tell me it's banned.
Am I question banned?
Oh, great.
Come the fuck on, bro. Just move on to the next shit.
Somebody
right
linked
now.
Me to that in one of my chats, and I'm like, you know what? This would be a great question for the podcast.
Aw, you were thinking of us. That's so sweet.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Like, you know, as much as Flip protests, like, he wasn't near on the level of ZP. ZP's like, no, I'm gonna tell you right now, no. Ask the fucking question, no.
I feel like ZP looked at it before today, though.
I saw it earlier today when I was moving the questions over to
I was
to
scared to click that shit because it was like, it was just a fucking. A link to a page. I was like, I'm not looking at that shit right now. I can't be on the work computer looking at that shit. Whatever it is, Tubby did post it in there.
Yeah, I post link. You know you should be looking at work.
Ugh.
Oh, all right. let's EP has a couple questions for us. First one is question for Diogenes. Does EP ever do the popcorn trick with you when you're all alone and watching a movie together?
Diogenes is an inanimate object, but but no, because I don't eat popcorn alone at my house.
I wait till family comes.
Hold on, I'm getting up.
Don't
getting
break
popcorn.
Out the good shit by myself.
I mean, you can't. I mean, well, you don't do the popcorn trick by yourself anyway, because then what? You're gonna reach in and touch your own dick? That's stupid.
I don't know, man. I said yes to Darnell Thomas. What do I
know? Son.
That's a valid point.
Can you hear my rebel here?
I think we know who our next guest needs to be.
Get the fuck out of here, bro.
Grunchkin has begged me for a long time to get like one of the RuPaul drag queen superstars on the show, but they never responded yet, so.
I wonder why.
I tried to get Willem on here, but yeah, that didn't happen.
Yeah, I don't even know what that is.
I don't know, Doc.
I'll link you later.
Willem Black?
Question for ZP. What night are you recording?
Every other Wednesday.
All right. Would you stick a block of cheese in your urethra for $2,500? I'll go first. And the next one is, would you melt it while it's in there for 2.5 million?
Yes.
The answer always to these questions is yes, because no. A, it's never going to happen, and B, that's a shitload of fucking money, so of course I fucking would.
The answer to the first one for $2,500 sticking a block of cheese in your urethra is no, because you're not going to fit a block up in that shit.
You haven't seen some of the videos.
I don't know
what kind of
urethras you guys are fucking working with.
Don't say you guys, dog. Say Kaiser and fucking
Cubby. But
Flip can
part
work it
two,
in.
My part one's a no, but the part two, if somehow magically I do shove it up there,
I mean,
because the body heat's going to melt it anyway, so.
Yeah. Ugh, dog. Oh.
I'm just going to say up front, cheese is very malleable, okay? You can contort it.
Not blocks of cheese, dude.
You're talking about a block of cheese.
If you work that shit, you can turn it into a nice, long, thin cylinder.
You ain't going to work a block of cheese up your dick.
Motherfucker, have you seen these hands? Have you seen these hands, motherfucker? I will work a block of cheese into this dick for $2,500.
Damn, dog. $2,500 only, dog.
And then when it melts, I get the $2.5 million. So
you'll die from blood loss before that shit melts.
I'm just saying.
Man, just think it. I don't know, bro. Come on. Yeah, I would melt it though if I got it in there.
Yeah, exactly.
But just the thought of trying to do the initial step is enough to make me want to fucking die. So.
I mean, I'm not even gonna try and put like a slice of American up there. It's not happening with a block.
Bro, I'm not trying to put anything.
Yeah, exactly.
In that shit.
Well, you know what's funny? When I was in sixth grade,
I was friends with string cheese.
No, I was friends with this one.
How many
dude.
Years ago was that?
ZP. It was long enough. But no, basically, I was friends with these couple guys. One of them was like a master thief and a bunch of times, and the other one was the son of a firefighter.
A master thief in sixth grade.
The dude stole a lot of shit, let's put it that way, okay? Anyway, I go over to this house one time, and like we somehow get on the subject of jerking it or whatever. He pulls out this string of pine straw. And he's like, this is what I use. I'm like, what do you mean this is what I use? He's like, I stick it down the hole.
Oh.
I was like, what do you mean? He's like,
yo,
I stick it down the hole.
Involuntary reaction, dog.
I was like, I couldn't believe it. I was like, why would you stick it in there?
What the fuck is pine straw, bro?
Like a pine needle, I think he means.
Yeah, pine needle, yeah. Drops from the pine tree.
Come on, bro.
But, you know,
took out your pine saw.
But the shit bothered me because, like, I'm like, I've never thought of seeing anything. I've never thought of thinking easy down there. And, like, and then I've seen since the, you know, in the BME Pain series, like, the fucking people, like, they stick all kinds of shit down
there.
Come on,
like, don't even get too detailed.
No, like, man, what? They stick, like large cylindrical type things down there, like, you would not think would fit, and they just keep mashing it in, and you're just like,
whoa. Come on, dog.
It's like in that Danzig video.
Yeah, I'm just like, the whole time I'm thinking, like, there is no way in fucking hell I would ever even put, like, the tip of a fingernail down there. These motherfuckers are shoving, like, giant rods down their shit.
Oh, shit.
And just like, I just don't get it, man. Like, but apparently some dudes are into that. Like, that was what he used. He kept his little pine straw in the bathroom.
And when
did he keep it in, like, fucking peroxide or something?
No.
When he just had it on the floor in the corner with piss all over.
A useless dick. I will get a share of his 2.5.
We would tell me that. I never do this shit. That's the whole thing. It's like,
you already
fucking said you would.
Oh, for the money, yeah.
You would try both.
Yeah, for the both money, things. Yeah. You know, I'm telling you, man.
I would never do this shit. Oh, yeah, for the money, yeah, yeah.
I would work that shit into, like, the smallest piece of string cheese you ever fucking saw.
No, you wouldn't be able to do it, dog. I'm sorry. Dude, that shit would just crumble or something.
You know what? Next time we go into the gym, I'm bringing
that fucking cheese. Don't bring no cheese.
You can make that cheese as thin of a string as you want, but it's going to be such a long string. We're going to the cardio level
with a block of cheese.
It's not going to work out for you, dog.
I'm going to work that shit into, like, the longest, thinnest piece of shit you've ever seen.
No, you're not, dog. You're going to be like, damn, I really can't do that shit.
Dude, let's find out.
Your reefer ain't long enough to fit that much cheese up in that shit.
It didn't say you had to fit all the way in.
It said you had to fit a block up in there.
Yes. Would you stick a block of cheese?
Not the tip of a piece of cheese. It doesn't say block the entire block
has to be consumed.
It doesn't say it, though.
Fine, I'll rub my dick on a piece of cheese and then I'll win. Yeah, you put,
no, it says, you mean. No, it says you have to put the block of cheese in there, but it doesn't say you have to fit the entire block at one
table,
time.
Table,
up to the tip.
I'm saying this as a friend who cares about you. Stop drinking.
Yeah, that did sound kind of heartfelt, dog. Like you're one step away from an intervention, dog.
I just want to work the block of cheese into a long piece of cheese.
And then put just the tip in your tip.
For money, though.
Why's it got to be a long string, then, if you're just putting a little bit in?
Chill out, dog.
What would Darnell do?
We gotta get a... Oh, my God.
LWDD.
Oh, God.
Oh, fuck.
All right. Let's see. EP's got another question. Question for the jug of the father. If you could suck your own dick, would you spit or swallow?
Now, what the fuck is wrong with people, dog?
Now, what's funny is I get scolded for answering things drunk, but the people who write this shit sober, like, they're cool.
No, they're
not.
That
sound like a they're cool response?
They're they got issues, bro. They got issues. What the fuck kind of question is that, dog?
I'm doing a cooking with Tubby, and I'm turning a block of cheese to a goddamn string. That shit's happening.
I don't know if that, like, will qualify with YouTube's terms of service.
I'm not sticking it anywhere. I'm just turning it into a long...
You gotta think about the audience, man. 12-year-olds.
Oh, no.
They gotta learn.
They gotta upgrade from fucking pine needles.
I'm telling you, man, that was the weirdest fucking shit ever. I'm just like... I didn't go over the house anymore.
Why do you remember that shit?
How could you not remember it? There's not enough alcohol in the world to cleanse you out of. Hey, I got a friend who sticks fucking pine straws on his dick.
Come on, bro.
So, you didn't answer the question, Jeff.
Fuck that question, dog.
We'll move on to a more team player then, because the next question is for Kaiser.
I'm never going to play on that team.
If you could suck Jugga's dick, would you spit or swallow?
Oh shit.
Is fucking is what's his name gonna be there with me?
Ooh.
Darnell Thomas, I gotta have some titties to look at.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Darnell will hold your
he's
hair.
He's gonna
back.
Be on the next show. He's gonna be a regular member. We're still SG6 now.
You know, one more person would still make us just five table.
Son, come on, dog.
Rebel
Yell taking L's.
Rebel Yell fucking Rebel Yell fucking them all up.
Yo, no, you gotta get back to Turkey, son.
You're gonna be six from now on.
Just wait till you slip up again in your dialect, motherfucker.
Oh my god, dog. Son, Tubby is getting flamed so bad tonight. Tubby's a damn good host for this
season. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. No matter what I say, it won't fucking top what just happened.
That's a yes. You would, and...
Oh, fuck. I ain't swallowing. I'd have to fucking spit. But do I still get the money?
There was no money.
There was no money, dog. There was none.
Thanks for being honest, though.
This made everything awkward for no money.
At least I'm putting cheese in my dick for money.
But table skipped the question.
What? No, I'm gonna ask that one. Come on, Nihil or Nail?
Nail.
Oh, I hate you guys so much.
I'm on Fuquay.
I'm glad I'm going on vacation. Fuck y'all. Now I'll ask, wait, you're recording tomorrow night? I don't know who copied who, but one of these motherfuckers copied each other.
No, unfortunately, we're not recording tomorrow night.
No, we're recording tonight. And we're playing Battlefield the whole time.
Oh, y'all have been quiet as fuck. No reactions to anything. Y'all must be playing like shit.
Sir, did you not understand how I would fucking manipulate cheese? I'm bringing a block of cheese to the gym.
Chill out, dog. Chill out, fucking stranger.
I'm reaching the gym, man. You think I'm pulling out chalk? It's gonna be a block of fucking.
If you're gonna do it,
pepper jack.
Make it Velveeta. That's already easy to work with.
Nah, fuck it. I'm going block, motherfucker. I'm going.
He's going fucking.
I'm spending $2.98 on a block of pepper jack, and I'm gonna work that shit to the longest stream.
Oh, he's going spicy too. I like that you're going spicy with it too.
Hell yeah.
It's gonna just know break in there. Some shit. Ugh, man. That's gonna be disgusting. Do it after we finish lifting.
Yeah, it'll be during cardio time.
I'm gonna miss that on purpose.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord, what you all learn about ZP? He said cardio.
No, I'm still talking about you with your fucking block of cheese. I don't give a shit about the fucking cardio. It's the cardio is the part that made that bad.
I know you don't care about cardio.
Tubby, no shots that you can fire back are gonna hit ZP tonight. He's pierced all your armor.
Well, that's it for listener questions. Oh, shit. Unless anybody has something to add.
Nah, Playboy.
Flip. I'll tell you, P, that you declined his question.
Okay.
All right, well, I want to thank everybody for joining us for Stonewall Jackson 5, episode 20. You all have a wonderful night.
Oh, you got all serious.
Yeah. Golly, man.
What am I supposed to get?
Be jolly or something when you exit.
I hope you all have a wonderful night.
I ain't stopped recording yet. If you want to do the exit, do the exit.
If you excuse me, I've got to go put my dog down.
Damn, you went dark.
Oh, man. Come on, man.
You ended it all morose and shit.
I just put on my surge, boy.
Oh, man.